The Philippine Professional Regulation Commission, or PRC, suspends a controversial policy against debt-saddled teachers. A resolution signed by Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma and PRC Acting Chair Jose Cueto Jr. put an end to the rule which prevented teachers from renewing their licenses due to unpaid debts. House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro earlier slammed the policy as illegal. She also believes loan sharks with connections in the PRC may be behind the scheme.
Hindi ko lang alam ano kung meron akong tsaba ang loan shark na ito doon sa PRC. Hindi ito accredited sa hindi ko maisip kung bakit nagkakaganon, na bakit nakakarating yung mga ganong ano doon sa PRC. Ito mga loan shark na ito, ang laki ng mga interest.
The Philippine Health Department denies a data leak from the government's contact tracing efforts is behind a surge of personal spam text messages. Its officer in charge, Maria Rosario Vergeri, says the contact tracing apps used in establishments were verified.
We don't think that that would be a cause or a factor from our contact tracing systems, as these contact tracing applications were vetted by the DICT as well as the Data Privacy Commission. So meron pong mga conditions and requirements for a specific local government to be able to establish their contact tracing application. So we don't think that the leakage in personal data came from this kind of contact tracing efforts of the government.
Other news, Vice President Sara Duterte visits teachers at a school in Siquijor Province. The country's concurrent education chief assured personnel at the Siquijor Integrated School her agency will address their classroom shortage problem. Duterte was in Siquijor over the weekend to join the province's 50th founding year. There, she distributed school supplies to students as well as food packs to families.
The Philippine Coast Guard Commandant defends his agency's actions in the West Philippine Sea following criticisms from Senator Aimee Marcos. The president's sister claimed during a recent Senate hearing that the Coast Guard is sitting on the sidelines and waiting amid a maritime dispute between the Philippines and China. Admiral Artemio Abu insists the Coast Guard has a continuous presence in the West Philippine Sea. He also notes they are constantly coordinating with the Chinese embassy and the Chinese Coast Guard. But Abu admits there's a need to intensify the talks.
We are in good coordination with the even with the ambassador of China. Reminder yan sa amin sa Coast Guard, we are taking it as a reminder na kailangan lalo nating pagbutihin ang trabaho ng Coast Guard diyan sa patrolya natin sa ating karagatan.
Abu spoke during the oath-taking for Coast Guard enlistment of some 1,450 individuals. This is said to be the biggest number of draftees in PCG history. The trainees will undergo 6 months of training in various Coast Guard bases.
Other news, the Philippine government hopes to remove barriers to the country's food security. ABS-CBN correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us for more on that story. Kat?
Ron, that's right. In a press conference here in Malacanang, Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says the cabinet found that there are quite many overlapping policies in various executive departments that hinder the government's push to attain food security. These include transportation issues, red tape, and the country's permit system. Cruz Angeles says the Department of Agriculture and the Department of Transportation and other agencies have agreed to work together on reviewing existing policies, as well as suggestions on how the Philippines can balance its importation with local production to address issues of over- and underproduction in the agricultural sector. Cruz Angeles says the meeting did not focus on a particular crop or type of meat. She adds details of these proposals will be announced at a later date when details have been finalized. Ron, if you recall, President Marcos last week tapped Indonesian officials to aid the Philippines fisheries sector, saying he could not accept that the archipelagic country was importing fish to address local supply woes. The Marcos administration is also trying to solve alleged hoarding and price manipulation of sugar that led to a supposed artificial shortage of the sweetener. Ron.
Katrina Domingo with that story. Thanks, Kat.